So we are given a binary tree, and each node we added one extra field to the structure of node, which is next. And right now each node is null. Next pointer of each node is null, right?
Mm-hmm.
So what we want to do is that we want to set the next pointer so that the next pointer points to next node in the current level. So next of A should be null, next of B should point to C, next of C should be null, and so on. Right? D should be E, E should be F. So the signature of the function will be something like this, that let's call the function set next pointer. So set next pointer will receive a pointer to the root node.
Okay.
If we are using Java, then this node will become class instead of structure, and pointer will become object, a reference, right?
Yeah.
So let's take the example of Java code only, right? So let's say this is a class node. All right. So how can we do it? So one was simple, right? Level order traversal. In the level order traversal, what we do is that we take a queue. Let's say we have a queue data structure with the, let's say we have a queue data structure, and that queue class has functions like insert, remove, and is empty, right?
Yeah.
So remove will remove the data from the queue, insert will insert the data in the queue, and is empty will check whether the queue is empty or not, right?
Yeah.
So we declare queue of type integers, right? Queue is equal, in this case it will be, sorry, of type node pointer, right? Queue of type node pointer. And what we do is that we store the address of the first node, right? So this is a normal level order traversal. In the normal level order traversal, we will keep a node of the level termination. So whenever the level terminate, we will store null pointer in the queue. So initially we will insert A and null pointer, which means that the first level is ending. So queue dot insert root, and before this we will check if root is equal to null. Then we should just return, don't do anything, right?
Yeah.
Similarly, if root is the only node, then also we don't need to do anything, right?
Yes.
So if root dot left is also equal to null, and root dot right is also equal to null, right? So if either root is the only node or root there is no node, in both the cases we will be returning, we will not be doing anything, right?
Okay.
Otherwise what we do is that we insert the root and we insert null pointer.
Right.
So null pointer in this case is a level terminator, right? So this is the normal level termination, right, that we are using, that we have already discussed in the class. So first we are inserting A, then we are inserting null. So then we remove A and we insert children of A. Children of A are B and C, right?
Yeah.
And we keep a track of previous node which is removed. So A becomes the previous. So let's say we have two things, previous node and current node.
Okay.
So initially previous node was null and A is the current node.
Yes.
So if previous node is null, then we can't do anything. Otherwise, if previous node is not null, then what we will do is that we will set previous dot next is equal to current.
Mm.
Right?
So we are linking.
Yeah, we are linking. Then we delete null. So null becomes the current node and A becomes the previous node. So we say that A dot next is null. So A dot next is null. Then B is removed. So when B is removed, previous is null and current is B. So we are not going to do this, right?
Yes.
When null is removed, we will insert another null. So that we keep a track of level termination. Right?
Level termination.
Yes. So null act as a level terminator. So whenever we delete null, we insert another null to indicate that the next level is already in the queue. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Then we delete B and we insert the children of B, which is D and E. Right?
Mm-hmm.
then we delete C. So when we delete C, B is the previous node and C is the current node. So next of B will be equal to C, right? So this part is done, right? And next of C, then we delete, and children of C will be inserted. So children of C means F is inserted in the queue, right? Then next is null. So now C becomes the previous and null becomes the next. So next of C will be null. So next of C is null. And whenever we hit a null, we insert another null in the queue, right? Then next node to be deleted is D. So null becomes the previous and D becomes the current, and we insert the children of D, which is I. Then next node deleted is E. So E becomes the current node and D becomes the previous node. So we will set D dot next is E, right? So D dot next is E, and we will insert the children of E. Children of E means that G will be inserted, right? And so on, right? So let me just write this function. So while not Q dot is empty,
previous.
While not Q dot is empty, we need a previous pointer also. So node node pointer previous is equal to null, right? And then we will say node pointer current is equal to Q dot remove. So we remove the current node, and then we check. There are two possibilities. One possibility is that if current is null, and second possibility is that current is not null. Right? These are the two possibilities.
Yes.
So if current is null, then what do? We insert the
another null.
Another null in the queue. Right. So Q dot insert null. And we do it only if Q is not empty, right?
Yeah.
If not Q dot is empty.
Okay.
All right. Otherwise, what we do is that we set the next pointer.
Yeah.
Right.
So previous dot next equal.
So
previous.
So in both the cases, what we do is that if previous is not null, if previous is not equal to null, then we will say previous dot next is equal to current, right?
Yes.
And then we check if current is null, then this. Otherwise, if current is not null, then we will insert current dot left and current dot right, right?
Yep.
So Q dot insert current dot left. Similarly, Q dot insert current dot right. We will insert the left and right children only when they are not null. If current dot left is not equal to null, only then insert it. Similarly, if current dot right is not equal to null, only then insert it. Right. So once this is done, then previous will be current. For the next iteration, this current will be previous, right?
Okay.
Right? Swami?
Yes.
All right. So we are not inserting anything. We are not printing anything. Just that we are setting the next pointers. Does it make sense?
Yes.
Right. How much time are we taking here? We are taking the same time because this is simple level order traversal of the tree. So we are taking on the order of n time and on the order of n extra memory also.
Yes.
Right. Now the main question was that I want to, you know, we want to do it without using extra memory. Right. We want to do it without using Q. So how can we do it without using Q?